Chapter 4. Color. The last button contains the color menu. Disk. If disk is selected, you see that when the button is blue, then you'll see the color disk. On the outside ring, you can choose your color. This ring is called the hue ring. Inside the circle, you can choose the value of your color. This part is called the saturation disk. When you have selected your color and value, you can start painting. You can also save your color in the swatches palette underneath. Tap on an empty swatch and you have saved your color as a swatch. Zoom in saturation disk. If you want more control over the saturation disk, you can zoom it in. Pinch with two fingers outward. The saturation disk is now zoomed in. You can now choose from more values in your color. To zoom out, pinch with two fingers inward. Stave tip. When you have selected a new color and want to return to the previous color, just tap and hold the color icon on the upper right corner. In this way, you can return to your previous color without opening a menu. Apart from the color ring, you have three more buttons. Classic. Classic is a classic color picker. With the top slider, you can choose your color. With the middle slider, you can choose the value of your color. And with the third slider, you can choose the tone of your color. Value. Value shows the HSB sliders and the RGB sliders. Drag them around to choose your color. On top of the menu, you see two color swatches. On the left, you see the current color, and on the right, the color you are making. Palettes. Palettes show the color swatches in Procreate. There are three default swatches in Procreate, but you can also make your own swatches palette. Tap on the plus sign in the upper right corner and create your own swatch palette. Tap on the untitled palette and name your palette Custom Palette. The default button is blue. This means it is active underneath all your color options. Select the color black in the color ring and tap on the swatches palette underneath. You just created your first swatch. You can keep adding swatches. Edit swatches. If you want to delete a swatch, press on it and hold it for a second. Then a pop-up appears with delete. Press on delete to delete a swatch. If you want to change the color of an existing swatch, first select your color in the color wheel. Then go to the swatch you want to change and tap and hold until the pop-up appears. Choose Set to change the color. You can also rearrange your swatches by holding it and moving it to a different position. Just drag them around and let go. If you want to delete a palette, swipe from right to left. Choose Delete to delete your palette. Share and import palettes. You can also share your palette with other users. Swipe from right to left on your palette. Choose Share. A new window opens with all the options to share. You can share it through mail or save it to the cloud, like iCloud or Dropbox. You can also save it to files on your iPad. Stave tip. This is a great way to make a backup of all the palettes you have created and imported. It is always good practice to make backups of your custom palettes. Importing palettes. You can import swatches from the Procreate forum or from the cloud. When you have received a link to a palette, tap on it. Then tap on Export. Then you'll see a new drop-down menu. Choose Open In and select Copy to Procreate. You have imported a new palette into Procreate. Sampling from Canvas. Between the two sliders in the sidebar, you find the Modify button. When you press on it with one finger or stylus and tap on your canvas, you can make a sample of the color that's on your canvas. The eyedropper tool appears. It is a circle that's divided in a top and bottom part. On the bottom, you see the current color that's selected, and on the top part, you see the color you are sampling from your canvas. As soon as you let go, the color is selected. Color drop. When you have drawn an enclosed shape on your canvas, you can fill it with the selected color. Tap on the color circle and drag it into the shape you want to fill. When you hold your stylus or finger on the canvas and swipe it from left to right, you can adjust the threshold of your fill. On the top of the screen, you can see the percentage of your threshold. Procreate remembers the latest threshold you've made. And you can always adjust it later. Stave tip. Color drop works best with graphic illustrations or more cartoony styles. But you can also use color drop to colorize your painting. Drag the color on part of your painting and use the threshold slider to let the color bleed into your painting. Want to learn everything about Procreate 4.3? Then get the Procreate 4 video manual on Apple Books or Vimeo On Demand for only $4.99. Learn all the features in Procreate 4.3. with over 2 hours of video tutorials. The links are in the description below this video.